So you are building a PC or just want to upgrade your old desktop or laptop and you need some RAM. So let's check it out. If you don't care about what exactly RAM does and what role it has in your system, then you can skip to the time shown on your screen right about now. If you want to find out, keep watching. Okay? Are they gone? Good. Now let's get into it. RAM, or random access memory, is somewhere in between the speed of your hard drive or SSD and that of your cache memory. If we were to make an analogy to something that everyone has done at least once, we would use food. The CPU wants data, so the CPU is your stomach, which wants food. The fastest and most readily available place where it can get food is your mouth. That would be the cache memory. Now the problem here is that neither your mouth nor cache memory can really store a lot of food or data at any time, only a few megabytes. On the other hand, a hard drive can store a lot of information. In our analogy, that would be a fridge. There is a lot of food in the fridge, but it would really slow down your eating if every time you wanted to put something in your mouth or cache memory, you had to go open up the fridge and dig around for whatever you're craving. Here's where the RAM comes in. The RAM is the plate sitting in front of you on the table. It stores things that your CPU is currently using or that it is planning to use in the near future. Similarly, the plate holds the food that you are currently planning to eat because it's more readily available than if it were in the fridge, and it isn't feasible to put everything in your mouth all at once. Okay, so now that we know what RAM does, it's time to figure out if it will work with the rest of your rig. When it comes to RAM compatibility, it almost always relates to your motherboard in some way. So before you get going, you want to find out what motherboard your system has. If you're not sure how to go about that, I have a video on that topic that you can find by clicking the card in the top right corner of the video. Go watch that if you don't know, and then come back here. Alright, first up, let's make sure that you are getting the right generation of RAM, which is usually expressed as DDR and then a number. Your motherboard will specify what type of RAM it supports, and it will most likely be DDR4 or DDR3. DDR2 is really old, and unless you have a PC that has seen quite a bit of history, it's unlikely for you to have that. You could also find motherboards that simply say they support DDR. That's basically DDR1, the original version, which is incredibly outdated by now. So if you have that in your rig, it's time for an upgrade. Now that you know the generation of RAM that you can get, let's ensure that you don't get too much of it. Every motherboard has a maximum amount of RAM that it supports. Whether it is 32, 64, 128, 256 gigabytes, or whatever other amount, make sure you don't get more than that, because that would just be a waste. It is also worth checking how many DIMM slots your motherboard has. Those are the slots where you plug your RAM in. There is usually 4 of them on normal size ATX motherboards, but the number goes anywhere from 2 on compact boards to 8 or even more on higher performance premium boards. For example, if your board has 2 slots, don't buy 4 sticks of RAM, obviously. Speaking of having more than one DIMM slot, if you are trying to upgrade a system, you want to make sure that you aren't mismatching RAM. Ideally, all of your sticks should be completely identical. You need to find out what RAM is already installed in that computer and see if you can get your hands on more of the same modules. If that is not an option, make sure that the frequency, also known as the speed of the RAM, capacity, and latency is the same for the RAM you are buying and the one that you want to pair it with, that being the one that is already in the computer you are upgrading. One thing that is easily overlooked and not really that often a problem is RAM clearance. Here's what I mean by that. If you have a particularly compact board, a really huge CPU cooler, or a super tall and bulky RAM module, you might find that the CPU heatsink will overlap the DIMM slots, not letting you plug your memory in. To prevent this, you can do a quick Google search for the CPU cooler that you are trying to pair with your motherboard and RAM, and see if you can find people complaining about RAM clearance issues. And usually, if no one's complaining about them, they're not there. While on the topic of size, it is good to know that if you want to buy a RAM for your laptop, then you need to go for SODIMM sticks, which look like this. Laptops use SODIMM slots, unlike the usual computer DIMM slots for DIMM sticks. So it's just a different size format, and other than that, the whole compatibility side of things is the same, so everything we've said before still applies here. So, to summarize, here's what you need to check when buying RAM. Is it the right generation? Am I getting the right size format? DIMM for PCs and so DIMM for laptops. Do I have enough slots on my motherboard? Does my motherboard support the amount of RAM that I'm planning to get? Will my CPU cooler leave enough room for my RAM to be mounted? Am I getting modules that have the same spec? If the answer to all of those questions is yes, then you are good to go. And that's about it. So I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you want to see more, you can click on the right to watch my latest video, or on the left to watch a random video, or just click the round channel icon in the middle to subscribe. And as always, this has been Vlad from Goodsauce Tech, and I'll catch you in the next one. Take care, bye bye.